In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a stunning 3D effect for your text or logo in Photoshop. This method is super easy to follow, and by the end, you'll be able to apply it to any design effortlessly. So, let's get started. First, I'll create a new document with the dimensions 1500 by 1000 pixels. This will be our workspace for designing the glowing 3D text effect. To set up the background, I'll use a gradient to create a smooth and visually appealing look. Once the background is added, I'll rename the layer to keep everything organized. Next, I'll click the plus icon at the bottom of the Layers panel to create a new layer. This layer needs to be converted into a smart object, so I'll right-click on it and select Convert to Smart Object. Doing this allows us to apply effects while still keeping the content inside editable. Now, I'll double-click on the Smart Object Layer's thumbnail. This opens a new document where we can add the text or a logo. Here, I'll type some text, resize it properly, and center it using the Move tool. Once the text is positioned correctly, I'll press Ctrl plus S to save the changes, and then return to the main document. As soon as I switch back, the Smart Object updates automatically. Now it's time to create the 3D effect. Right-click on the Smart Object layer and open the blending options. The first thing I'll do is enable Color Overlay and choose a dark gray shade. This helps in getting a solid base before applying highlights and shadows. Then I'll enable Bevel and Emboss. For this, I'll set the style to Inner Bevel. Keep the technique on Smooth and push the depth up to 1000%. The direction should be set to Up, with the size at 0 pixels and soften at 1 pixel. I'll keep the angle at 90 degrees and the altitude at 10 degrees, while making sure to untick the Use Global Light option to have full control over the lighting. For the highlight mode, I'll select a medium gray color, change the blending mode to Normal, and set the opacity to 100%. Similarly, for the shadow mode, I'll use black. Set the blending mode to Normal, and also increase the opacity to 100%. These settings will create a solid 3D structure with proper highlights and shadows. You can also experiment with different colors to achieve variations in the effect. Once everything is set, I'll hit OK to apply the changes. Now that the base 3D effect is complete, we will do some transformation. Press Ctrl plus T to open the Transform tool. We will use the arrow keys to move the text by 1 pixel in any direction, depending on where you want the extrusion effect. Since I want the extrusion to be towards the right and downward, I'll move my text in the opposite direction by pressing the up arrow and left arrow keys once. This will shift the text 1 pixel in both directions. Press Enter to confirm the transformation. Next, I'll hold Ctrl plus Shift plus Alt and keep holding these keys. Then press T on your keyboard. This will create a copy of the text in the same transformed position. Now, keep pressing T repeatedly until you achieve the desired extrusion effect. Once the process is complete, rename the topmost layer to Main Layer. Then, select the layer just below it and scroll down until you find the bottommost Smart Object layer. Hold the Shift key and click on this layer to select all them together. Now, press Ctrl plus G to group these selected layers. Finally, rename this group to Extrusion. Now let's add some color to our text. I'll open the blending options for the main layer and untick Color Overlay since we don't need a solid color anymore. Next, I'll move to Gradient Overlay to add a smooth gradient effect. Here, I'll choose a gradient with shades of blue. This part is not strict to follow. You can choose any color combinations or settings based on your design preference. Once the gradient is applied, I'll head over to Bevel and Emboss to refine the 3D effect. The style remains set to Inner Bevel, but this time, I'll change the technique to Chisel Hard. This makes the edges sharper and gives the text a more defined look. Then I'll set the depth to around 150%, while keeping the direction set to Up. Now, I'll adjust the size to 2 pixels and leave Soften at 0 pixels, ensuring the edges remain crisp. The angle will be set to 90 degrees while the altitude will be increased to 30 degrees. For the highlight mode, I'll select pure white as the color. I'll set the blending mode to screen and adjust the opacity to around 70 to 80% to keep it subtle yet effective. For the shadow mode, I'll use pure black to enhance the contrast. I'll change the blending mode to multiply and set the opacity to around 70%. Now, let's refine the effect even further. Click on the contour option. Here, open the curve panel and select the S-curve for smoother shading and depth. Make sure to tick anti-alias to enhance the quality. Finally, set the range to 100% for maximum effect. Next, let's add a stroke to enhance the text. First, select gradient as the fill type, then adjust the gradient colors. For the first stop, choose a dark gray, and for the second stop, select a light gray. Set the size to around 2 pixels, and change the position to inside. Now, set the blend mode to lighten, and increase the opacity to 100%. Tick the overprint box, keep the style as linear, and angle to 90 degrees. Set the scale to 150%, and choose classic as the method. The stroke is done. Now let's add a subtle glow effect to this layer. I'll go with a blue color, then set the blend mode to screen, and adjust the opacity to 70%. The size will be around 7 to 8 pixels. This will create a soft glow around the subject. And it's done. And finally, let's add a drop shadow to enhance the effect. I'll open the extrusion group layer and select the bottommost layer. Then, I'll double-click on it to open blending options. From here, I'll enable drop shadow. Now, it's time to fine-tune the settings. I'll adjust them until the shadow looks just right. Once you are happy with how it looks, click OK to apply the changes. Now change its name to Shadow. The final step is to bring everything together and add a finishing touch with a gradient. First, hold Ctrl and left-click on each layer to select them. Then press Ctrl plus G to group them. I'll rename this layer to 3D Effect. Now double-click on the group to open Blending Options. Now select Gradient Overlay. For the gradient, choose a basic black and white preset. Set the blend mode to soft light, and enable dither for a smoother transition. Adjust the opacity to 70%. Choose linear as the style, and set the angle to 140 degrees. Finally, set the scale to 50%, and select classic as the method. And that's it. Our 3D text effect is complete. But we're not done just yet. Now, let me show you how this effect looks on a logo. First, open the group containing all the layers and double-click on the thumbnail of the main layer. This will open the Smart Object document, where we can replace the text with our logo. For this example, I'll use a dragon logo. To insert it, go to File, then click on Place Embedded. Locate your logo file and click Place. Resize the logo as needed. Once it's properly centered, hit Enter to confirm the transformation. Now, press Ctrl plus S to save the smart object. Then head back to the main document. As you can see, the 3D effect is instantly applied to the logo. This was super easy, right? Now, if you want to tweak the design further, you can change the colors in the blending options or even modify the background. Just make sure the colors follow a theme to keep the design aesthetically pleasing. Here are some other variations of this effect. If you're still watching, we've dropped a PSD file of this effect in the description. Make sure to check it out. And if you want a tutorial on adding a glow effect to this 3D text, let us know in the comments. We'll drop a video on that topic soon. But before you go, make sure to subscribe, and if you found this tutorial helpful, leave a like to support us. I'll see you in the next one.